Datuk Stephen Mundau dilahirkan pada 31 Mei 1965 dan mula menyertai tentera pada 7 Januari 1978. Berkhidmat selama 41 tahun, beliau menamatkan baktinya dalam tentera yang bersara wajib dengan jawatan terakhirnya Lieutenant General pada 2019. Berpengalaman luas, berkhidmat 35 tahun di Semenanjung Malaysia dan 8 tahun di Sabah dan Sarawak. Menjadi anak Iban pertama menjawat tugas besar dalam ketenteraan termasuk dilantik sebagai Panglima 1 Division Tentera Darat Malaysia dan Panglima Medan Timur Tentera Darat Malaysia. Mendirikan rumah tangga bersama Datin Jacqueline kurniakan dua anak lelaki. Beliau merupakan pemegang sijil Sarjana Pengajian Strategik Amerika Syarikat selain diploma di Filipina dan Kuala Lumpur. Selepas bersara pada 2019, Stephen berkhidmat sebagai penjawat awam selama 4 tahun.
Yeah, so I was not part of Sarawak Ranger or the Iban Tracker. Jadi kita satu lagi ni, Iban Tracker ni adalah kumpulan kita punya orang-orang muda yang dipilih oleh British, tentera British untuk membantu mereka buat trekking dan sebagainya di Melaya melawan komunis di sana. Okay, so they are good in trekking, they are good in jungle operation dan sebagainya. Tetapi mereka ni bukan serdadu They are civilian tapi digaji ataupun diemploy oleh battalion yang British yang ada sebagai tracker untuk membantu mereka tracking, untuk membantu mereka menghidu, untuk mencari musuh dan sebagainya. Because our Iban trackers ni, budak-budak yang Iban trackers ni, anggota Iban trackers, they are good in jungle operation. Okay, dia boleh hidu musuh, dia boleh hidu mencium bau musuh, mencium bau binatang dan sebagainya. Dia boleh tengok tanda-tanda di mana yang dah dilalui oleh binatang ataupun ataupun manusia dan sebagainya. So they were employed as a tracker. Tracker maksud dia tracking. Tracking. And they were good. They were good in jungle operations sebab British employed dia orang. Jadi dia orang ni is 1948 to 1952 di Melaya. Ada juga dia orang ni balik nanti dia akan join Sarawak Ranger. Okay, so dia ada tiga kategori. So Sarawak Ranger, Malaysian Ranger and the Iban Tracker. Iban Tracker. So pengalaman dan experience yang saya pada ketika itu kita banyak laksanakan projek Jiwa Murni. Yeah, this are getting close to me. That was under the apa tu, the National Blue Ocean Strategy yang kita buat dulu. Okay, so sebagai komander saya bertanggungjawab kepada seluruh aktiviti ini untuk Sabah dan Sarawak. Okay, dan kita banyak laksanakan projek-projek jurni ini, projek-projek mendekati rakyat, membantu rakyat daripada segi banyaklah engineering, daripada segi membuat jalan and then also membantu membina rumah, ada yang rumah panjang, membaiki rumah dan sebagainya, dan termasuk juga dengan projek bakalan air. That was the lot of activity. So as a commander I was all over Sarawak dengan untuk membantu dan mendekati rakyat. So we in the military as a part of the Medan Timur, 1 Division, 9 Brigade, 3 Brigade bekerjasama dengan agensi-agensi yang lain untuk membantu mendekati rakyat dan sebagainya. Sebagai seorang pegawai pemerintah talent, saya tak boleh lupakan adalah insiden Al Maunah. Yeah, you have heard about the Al Maunah in Perak, di mana ada sekumpulan ini yang telah merompak senjata daripada camp di Greek ya, pada waktu malam dia bawa, lepas tu dia pergi ke tempat pertahanan mereka. Okay, I was one of the battalion commander who was involved in that operation. Okay, the whole of my battalion was deployed. Kita buat cordon, okay. Dan my UCS platoon adalah specialist platoon yang untuk risikan. They crept, they bergerak waktu malam, and they crept close to the enemy. Sehingga satu daripada ketua dia kena tembak oleh kumpulan Al-Gumunah ni. Tapi kena tembak di sebelah kiri. Okay, tapi tidak kena, ada peluru tembus daripada depan sampai ke belakang ni, tapi tulang tidak kena. So I thought maybe that fellow is ada budak Sarawak tu, dia Sarjan Ukun. Mungkin dia ada pengaruh lah. Pengaruh tu tidak tembus. Kau bayangkan, it's here, you know. Had it been on the lead, it would have been ni kan, very fatal kind of a shot. Tapi dia ada. But these guys, they are good guys. They crept right up to the enemy. Okay, tetapi agaknya mungkin bila dah terlalu dekat, jadi kena tembak oleh mana. And he still alive, ada dekat sini. Yeah. So saya juga terlibat dengan ni Al-Mawna. Ya, saya Iban yang pertama ataupun Dayak yang pertama untuk menjadi general pada ketika itu. I think it was basically banyak luck lah. Luck and I would say lucky, and I was at the right time at the right place. Dah tak ada orang lain dulu, maka saya pun dipromosikan. Okay, so however, walaupun saya kata begitu, tapi saya dapat banyak backing juga lah. Yeah, banyak backing daripada kita punya political masters, political friend dan sebagainya daripada Sarawak, yang pada ketika itu secara kebetulan dia are looking for East Malaysian to be promoted, sebab dia nampak macam tak ada orang daripada East Malaysia, khususnya daripada Sarawak yang ada general. So saya ketika itu I was a full colonel, and there I was, you see. So I was at the right time in the right place, so I was promoted. But again, thinking back, saya rasa saya pun ada bagus jugalah, so that to be able to be noticed. As I said, I always wanted to be the best, and I think my record stand, my record shows it all, right? That I am one, probably one of the best, if not the best, among all the colonel at that point of time. So there was this luck, this opening of they wanted an East Malaysian general in Sarawak. Okay, so there you are. I was at the right time. So it was maybe to a part also maybe act of God lah. So thank you God lah. That is just what we did, because at that point of time we proved this, because we were also involved in the Lahad Datu punya incident. Okay, my whole battalion was involved in this Lahad Datu punya. Three ranger under the command of Colonel one I didn't name them. Okay, they were deployed in the one day, and these boys, they were the peak of the Lahad Datu incident. Well, I was not deployed. I was the reserve commander here in Cebu. But the boys were in the forefront, and they performed, I would say, very, very well and excellently during that Lahad Datu punya incident in 2013. Okay. My advice to the young people, okay, to the young and the upcoming generation, first, you must be appreciative of what we have now. Must be thankful. Must be thankful. Of course, there may be some, you know, something which is short, something which is not so neat, but appreciate what is the positive rather than the negative. We must preserve the peace, the unity and the harmony that we have now. That is very, very precious. And to preserve that, everybody have to give and take. To my idea, kita kena sacrifice. Okay, sacrifice. We must develop and grow. Okay, we must develop and do catching up with the other countries. We must do money. Yeah. Thirdly, Sarawak, as I said, belong to us. There have to be some level of patriotic patriotism among us and a lot of sacrifices. Yeah. We need to benchmark with the other countries. How effective they have to, we need to learn from them, and we need to work with them. These are the work of the young people, and the young people must be able to grow. Okay, so in the future you will be at par lah. Harapan kita terus maju with integrity. Now integrity is important. Okay, bermakna dengan tulus ikhlas kita laksanakan itu. Kita nak maju dengan terus ikhlas. We hope there will still be, you know, peace, keselamatan, prosperity, kemajuan daripada negara kita. Right? Daripada segi tadi lah, ekonomi, politik, daripada segi integrasi kita, unity kita sebagai satu rakyat. Kan, yeah. There have to be a high level of tolerance di antara kita, sebab kita ni multi berbagai kaum, berbagai agama, berbagai kefahaman dan sebagainya. So it is important that kita mempunyai satu tolerance, satu level tolerance yang tinggi di antara satu sama lain. Kita tak naklah ada perasaan wasangka, perasaan ini dan sebagainya. Sama-sama maju, sama-sama bergerak. Okay? Kalau ada yang tinggal, ada yang lemah tu, dia kena dibantu. Ada yang kuat tu, kena bantu yang lemah. Yang lemah tu pun kena berusaha untuk mengikut jalan. Okay? We have to be together. Then only kita boleh dianggapkan sebagai maju. My hope is Sarawak will then be able to ride on this wave together with the other countries. You the commander now, but to me, no veteran or no soldier should be left behind. You know, even until dia sudah menjadi veteran, kita tak boleh biarkan dia bersorangan tanpa diuruskan dengan baik. Kita pun membantu veteran. That's why I volunteered myself to be in one way or the other to perjuangkan hak-hak veteran, yeah? Dengan peluang yang beri peluang yang lebih baik kepada mereka untuk terus hidup. Okay, then we are our together, so we got to grow together. Eh? Most important, as I said, do not lose what we have now. Do not lose what we have now. We have to protect it at whatever means. Just don't gamble it away. Okay? Fikirkanlah apa yang kita patut buat untuk supaya apa keadaan yang ada sekarang ni dikekalkan ataupun diperbaiki untuk kita maju ke hadapan. Okay? Ucapan selamat menyambut hari ulang tahun lah. 60 Merdeka untuk Sarawak. Kita doakan, kita ucapkan tahniah, kita ucapkan syabas.
Follow us, I read e-paper News Sarawak Tribune and Suara Sarawak on smartphones. Register free app SDSS e-paper now.